Hello, my name is Aaron Mick. I'm shooting this video at the Arkansas State Capitol Building in Little Rock. This memorial is titled Testament and is comprised of 9 sculptures made primarily by local artist John Deering. Deering has made dozens of sculptures that are placed around Little Rock and the state of Arkansas, as well as a few works that were made for out-of-state locations. He is also a cartoonist for the Democrat Gazette and an avid painter. He has 2 other sculptures on the Capitol lawn, the Arkansas Vietnam Veterans Memorial and the Medal of Honor Monument. Almost all of his outdoor sculptures were cast in bronze at the Shidoni Foundry in Santa Fe, New Mexico. Deering was raised in Camac Village, a suburb of Little Rock. He showed interest in art since childhood and majored in fine arts at the University of Arkansas at Little Rock. He was a clear choice to make this memorial because of his ties to Little Rock and his previous outstanding work for the Capitol. These sculptures were made to resemble the first African-American students at Little Rock Central High School. They faced extreme opposition, especially on their first day of attendance. The governor of Arkansas at the time was Orville Faubus. It was Governor Faubus who ordered the Arkansas National Guard to stop the Little Rock Nine from entering school on that day in September of 1957. As Terrence Roberts, one of the 9, put it in a speech in 2006, life under the prevailing conditions was no life at all. Eventually, President Eisenhower himself had to intervene, sending in federal troops to guard each student personally while tempers were still high. The statues are very naturalistic, made to represent the 9 students as they looked almost 60 years ago. The statues were made of clay and then cast in bronze, giving them a dark brown hue. This color actually lends to the subject of the piece, which is prejudice against African Americans. The statues are not perfectly smooth in texture, giving the appearance of ruffled clothes, while the faces are smoother than the rest of the bodies, showing the innocence of the subjects. The statues are of natural human height and show the students walking and looking around in bewilderment, representing how they felt on their first day of integrated high school. The best methodology with which to look at this work of art would be iconography. While it is an aesthetic work, the true importance comes from the event that it was made to commemorate. The fact that the sculptures are life-size makes you feel like you've been transported back in time to the chaos outside of Central High School. Much influence seems to come from the Greek, who originated the bronze statue, as well as the custom to make sculptures life-size. This can be called early classical or classical style. The sculpture Warrior from Riace, for example, very closely resembles the style of Testament. The warrior is life-size and cast in bronze, with a similar rough texture all around, but a smoother face. Bronze was also used in the Hellenistic period and in ancient Rome. The Boxer is another work similar in style to the Testament, in that it is cast in bronze and life-size. Also, it is made to represent a normal human form, not idealized as a god, although he is very muscular due to his being an athlete. Another bronze statue is that of Marcus Aurelius from Rome. This is similar to Testament in that it was made to represent a specific person and historical event. I have multiple connections to Testament that made me decide to make it the focus of my presentation. The primary artist, John Deering, is my uncle. I can remember visiting him in the studio and seeing the progress on the clay sculptures. It was a big undertaking, and it was amazing to see the sculpting process in action. I am also proud that he was selected for such an important project. It represents one of the most significant events in Arkansas history. I'm proud that our government was able to overcome its initial adverseness to change and accept these students in the beginning of integration in Arkansas schools. It is important that the Arkansas Capitol Building displays this on its lawn so that we can remember the struggles and advancement that had to happen in order to make our state what it is today. I also enjoy the aesthetic aspects, specifically the fact that the statues are life-size and stand normally and in the open, just as anyone else would. One can walk among them and imagine how they felt walking into school during that time of extreme adversity. Again, my name is Aaron Madey, and thank you for watching my presentation on Art You Can See in a Day.